In today's video, I'm going to share with you how can you build your first home studio for music production purposes under 30,000 rupees or less. So watch till the end and let's get started. The links to all the equipments in the video is listed down below in the description. So if you want to buy these things, you can check the links in the description below. Now keep in mind, I'm not including the softwares and the computer in this list because I'm assuming you already have a computer with 4 gigs of RAM and a decent processor in it. And you can get a software such as Audacity or Reaper for really cheap when you're starting out. So I'm not adding those things in this list. Also, I'm not including the monitoring speakers in this list because at this stage, you probably don't need it. Most of your work will be done on a decent pair of monitoring headphones, which I'll be recommending in this video. So watch till the end. At the end of this video, I've also included a bundle which consists of everything which I'm going to tell you in this video except a MIDI controller. So if you are interested for that, wait for it. But before starting, if you are new here, I'm Ronak. I make informative content just like this related to music production, audio engineering and music composition. I upload new video every week, so if this interests you, you can press the subscribe button. So let's dive into the gear. I'm gonna give you 4 options of gear for each category and you can choose the one which suits you the best according to the price and your preferences. The first category in this list is audio interface. An audio interface is the most important element of your home studio setup because it helps you in connecting your guitar, your keyboard, your instruments, your microphones, whatever outboard gear which you want to connect, you can connect it to your audio interface and then record into your computer inside your DAW. Audio interface also helps with the latency issue and you can get a very good quality recording with an audio interface, which you can't achieve with an inbuilt audio card of your computer. So the first and the cheapest interface in this list is the Behringer Euphoria UM2. It costs for around 4,600 rupees. So if you are on a very tight budget, you can go for this interface. The second interface is the Scarlett Solo by Focusrite. It costs for around 10,000 rupees and it's also a very good interface under this price range. The third interface in the list is the Presonus Studio 24C, which costs around 13,900 rupees. This is also a very good interface which you can choose. The fourth and the final interface in this list is the Focusrite Scarlett 2i2 3rd Gen. The Focusrite Scarlett 2i2 and the Presonus Studio 24C is the most future-proof solution for your studio. Even I have used my Focusrite 2i2 for around 5 years and now I'm planning to upgrade it to a new interface. So if you are planning to have a future-proof solution, you can choose any of these, either Presonus or Scarlett 2i2. But if you are on a very tight budget, you can go for either the Scarlett Solo or the Euphoria UM2. All these interfaces are really good and will serve you really well on your first home studio setup. Moving on to headphones. When you're producing music, judging whether your music is sounding good or bad is quite difficult if you're listening it on a consumer pair of headphones or speakers. So investing in a decent pair of studio monitoring headphones which have a flat or neutral frequency response helps you in achieving a really good mix and will help you in judging your music better. So the first headphone in this list is the Shure SRH440. Which was also my first headphones when I started producing music. It cost for around 7,300 rupees. The second headphone is the Sennheiser HD 280 Pro, which comes for around 6,299. Third headphone in the list is Audio-Technica ATH M30X, which comes for around 6,500 rupees. The fourth and the final headphone is the Sony MDR-7506, which comes for around 7,490 rupees. These headphones have a really good reputation in this industry and they are being used by industry professionals since a long time. And I have personally used these headphones, that's why I'm recommending you. So you can choose any of these headphones, all of these headphones will serve you really well and it's really good for starting. Moving on to microphones. Now this may be subjective, maybe you're a kind of person who doesn't want to record vocals or any instrument. But at some point in your production journey, you might require a microphone to record samples or vocals or any instrument. So having a microphone in your arsenal is not a bad thing. In the list of microphones, the first microphone is the Shure SM57 microphone, which is a legendary microphone specially used for miking guitar amps, instruments, and also for vocals. Metallica's guitarist James Hetfield has also used this microphone for recording his vocals on one of their albums. And even for this video, you can notice this microphone is a Shure SM57 microphone. It's a really great microphone. It's a cardioid polar pattern microphone and a dynamic microphone which doesn't capture the noise which is unwanted. It's really great for home studio purposes because if you don't have an isolated environment, you can use this microphone. The good thing about Shure SM57 is that it's a cardioid polar pattern and it's a dynamic microphone, so it doesn't need a phantom power to power it up. The Shure SM57 costs for around 7,680 rupees. The second microphone in the list is the SE Electronics X1A. It's a really versatile microphone. It's specially marketed for vocalists, but it's really capable of recording guitar cabinets and instruments. It's a condenser microphone with a cardioid polar pattern, so you will need phantom power to power this microphone. This costs for around ₹7,990. The third microphone in the list is Behringer C1. This is also a really great microphone if you are on a really tight budget. It costs for around ₹4,000 and you can get a really good recording out of it. So if you are on a really tight budget, you can go for this microphone. The fourth and the final microphone is the MXL440 condenser microphone, which costs for around ₹7,290. So you can choose any of these mics according to your preference. Moving on to MIDI controllers. MIDI controllers are a really great tool for recording and playing virtual instruments from your digital audio workstation or music production software. Now you don't necessarily need a MIDI controller. You can draw MIDI notes through your computer mouse or your computer keyboard, but having a dedicated MIDI controller really helps with your workflow. The number one controller in our list is the M-Audio KeyStation Mini 32 controller. It's a 32 key controller, which you can take it on the go. It fits easily inside your backpack, and it was also one of my first MIDI keyboard controllers. The M-Audio KeyStation Mini 32 costs for around ₹5,799. The second MIDI controller is the Nectar SE25, which is also a mini MIDI controller. So you can get it for around ₹5,000 and it's a 25 keys controller. The third MIDI controller in our list is the Akai MPK Mini. It's a really great controller if you are into beat making. It has 8 drum pads which you can use for finger drumming, and it has 8 controllers, and it's a really phenomenal controller. And it also fits in your backpack and you can take it anywhere. It costs for around ₹10,000. The fourth and the final MIDI controller in our list is the Nectar Impact GX49, which is a full-size controller with full-size keys. So if you are planning to learn a keyboard or you want a long-term use for your MIDI controller, you can go for this MIDI controller. It costs for around ₹10,000. So one note before moving ahead, if you already have a keyboard lying at your home, you can use that keyboard. If it has a MIDI output, you can connect that keyboard to your computer and use it as a MIDI controller. Now moving on to the last and the final category, which is the bundles. The first bundle in the list is the Scarlett 2i2 third gen bundle, which includes a microphone, a microphone cable, a headphone for monitoring, and an audio interface. So if you don't want to buy things separately, you can go for these bundles. These two bundles are really great. The Scarlett 2i2 bundle costs for around ₹25,600. And the second bundle is the PreSonus Studio 96 bundle, which includes the same thing, which is a microphone cable, a headphone, and an audio interface. So you can choose any of these bundles. Both of these brands have a really good reputation in this industry, so you can choose any of these. The PreSonus bundle costs for around ₹19,900. If you think that this video was really helpful for you in building your home studio setup, you can press the like button, and if you haven't subscribed, you can click the subscribe button. Thank you guys for watching this video. I hope it will be helpful for you in building your home studio, your first home studio, and I'll see you around in the next video.